Welcome to The Public Storyteller. My name is Michael Stock. I do a weekly folk and acoustic music radio program on WLRN in Miami. And with Dr. Karen Neal, a professional storyteller and author, we bring you The Public Storyteller, a weekly program that features amateur and professional storytellers. Today, we have an opportunity to dig into our archives and Karen, who's telling their story today.
This is from Grace Johnson.
Many years ago, back in the early 70s, in Boca Square on 10th Street in Southwest Boca, it was a great neighborhood. We had lots of fun. There were a lot of parties and camaraderie. And two couples, my friend and I, decided to have a garage sale. So we pooled our joint stuff that we culled from our closets and our garages. We obviously didn't have basements, but we culled enough stuff to have a really nice garage sale. And we spent some time putting prices on everything, and the garage sale was to be held Saturday and Sunday. Well, on Friday night, the Johnsons had to go out, and so Ellie and her husband came over and finished pricing everything and stayed there just in case any early customers came along. Well, I guess they got bored because when the Johnsons got home, they found for sale signs on everything. There was a for sale sign on the bed. There was a for sale sign on the toilet. There was a for sale sign when they opened the refrigerator on different pieces of food in the refrigerator. Cute little handmade for sale signs everywhere you looked. So the Johnsons went to bed that night, but they got up really early the next morning. And when Ellie and her husband got up and looked outside their window, there was a professional for sale sign in front of their house. Their house was for sale. Oh, they couldn't let that one go. So a little bit later, after the garage sale got going and everybody was very busy, they managed to put a for sale sign on the Johnson's car, which, of course, we had moved out of the garage and was sitting in the street. I don't think anybody really made any offers, but I know my husband really quickly got that for sale sign off the car because he wasn't ready to sell it yet. So the garage sale proceeded a little longer, and there was a lot of laughter and camaraderie. And the next thing you know, the Johnsons had managed to place for sale signs on the back of Ellie's children, who were, I think, around 8 or 12, something like that. And there the kids go off from the garage sale with the for sale signs on their back. And of course, the neighbors around are looking at each other, but they kind of knew Ellie and I, so they didn't have too much to say. They just kind of laughed at it. And it was, I have to say, a very successful garage sale. We sold just about everything that we had there. What was left over, I think we sent to Goodwill. But the best thing was that we all had a lot of fun and a lot of laughs. And it was a good way to make money and get rid of your junk and laugh all at the same time.
Grace Johnson with a story about her practical joke friends she has.
Yeah, this is a kind of a wisp of a story. I mean, it's very short and sweet. I loved it because it's so evocative of a friendship, of a time, of a neighborhood. Also, it's the kind of one-upmanship in a story that is always fun. Where's it going to go? One does something to one goes back. We started out with for sale signs on the food and the refrigerator and the toilet, and we got all the way to for sale signs on the children. And as she was telling the story, I could just picture the laughing back and forth and the plotting between the two couples of what they were going to do next.
And it was so good-natured. There was nothing harmful in their practical jokes.
Unless possibly somebody had made an offer for the children.
Yes, yes. What was a little off-putting was her referring to herself in the third person. That was unusual.
Yeah, I noticed that definitely, and a couple of things may have been happening. One of it may have been if so as not to have to say my husband and I or my husband and me, you know, just a quick way of saying it, the Johnsons. And another thing, it just sort of makes the story for me almost a little more universal. I don't know, maybe I'm reading too much into this, but it seems like this isn't just a thing about her. This is the Johnsons versus the other couple. And it just took on a life of its own, like the Johnson team. And so I thought it was kind of fun that she did that. A little confusing to some people, perhaps. The Johnsons are herself and her husband.
It took me a couple seconds to realize what she was talking about, that she was referring to herself when she said the Johnsons.
Yeah. But the imagery in that story, I mean, did any listener, I challenge any listener to say they didn't have a visual in their minds of for sale signs on every little thing with a toothpick in the refrigerator or on the kids.
It was very cute.
It really was. And sometimes it's fun just to have a fun story that's got no other purpose than making us laugh. Many people think that folk tales were designed to teach or were designed to inspire or moralize or something. And there are different points of view on that, but I have read and I believe that folk tales were just meant to be fun. Now, not that this is a folktale. It's a personal memoir. It's a type of folklore. But folktales like Br'er Rabbit stories or Jack and the Beanstalk or something like that, sometimes a story is just a story and we're just meant to laugh and go on with our day. And I think this is one of those.
And it wasn't a joke. It wasn't a punchline, but it was just a fun thing to listen to.
Yeah, it was really lovely.
Thanks for bringing that story in, Karen. Dr. Karen Neal is a professional storyteller and author. My name is Michael Stock. The Public Storyteller is a weekly podcast broadcast out of the studios of WLRN in Miami.